There we were, spring bunnies, so excited, so thrilled, the newness of it all.
Yeah, and then for the first time ever, use Uber service. One thing I found out, a lot of these Uber drivers have personalities of wet mom. But anyway, he got us there safely through the security entrance of the port Everglades, and we managed to skip the whole luggage thing. And
yeah, we went small. That was your luggage right there, that black backpack. And what else did you have?
I had a small one to have my flip flops and a few things and fit in the other. Yeah, I've never seen these people that take like two or three luggages for a 5-day cruise. And then end up wearing the same thing all day because they're just out in the pool.
Yeah, because it's too hot to wear anything else.
Exactly.
We had a wonderful first impression. You know, we get picked up within like 3 minutes of dialing Uber. It was really cool. But like you said, the guy had a personality of a wet mop. He just got us there, but thankful, you know.
Made it all in one piece. And there we were, just sitting there waiting to be allowed in. You know, you have to show the passport, you know, the whole security check that happened ever since 9/11. Traveling's never been the same, but we're all there.
We were all there because we fell asleep that night and got up that morning, and we were chipper and ready to go. Got ready to go early, and here we are waiting. I didn't know we had to wait to get on the on the ship.
It wasn't that long. It was probably like 15 minutes or so, because we did get there pretty early.
Yeah, we got there early, so the ship wasn't even ready. The ship hadn't even opened its doors yet. You notice here in this next shot, people were making hand signs and waving at the camera. Yeah. I didn't notice it, but I went like that, and then I went back down.
So
they're all being interested. Yeah, they went, hey, wanted to get in our shot. But yeah, people as excited as we were to be a part of this 5-day Western Caribbean cruise to... See, look at.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. I didn't even notice that until I saw it. Right.
Yeah, they're like, okay, is that our cue?
They were excited, just as excited as we were to watch the wait go up. As you can see, as you will be able to see later on in this video, there was not a short abundance of food, right? And there we are. They said it was time to get on, so
we are making our way to the ship. And that's got to be the longest walk to get to the ship.
It is. It's like walk the plank. They walk the plank onto the boat.
Yeah.
It's, go through security after security after security. It's like security of security has security.
They can never be too secure.
No.
That's what it seemed like. And here I'm like, God, over there you're carrying around this
heavy
backpack.
The backpack was about half the size of you. Almost the size of you. And then these people wanted to sell all their pictures and the murals and stuff. It's like, I could have taken a picture of us right in front of it if they would have just moved away and let me use the backdrop.
But no, they want you to buy their package.
Yeah.
One of the things I noticed about cruising is not just the money that you have to pay to cruise, it's all the stuff.
And this is like get smart, you know, it's like go through the door, up the elevator, into the other secret control.
Through the woods to grandma's house.
Over the river, through the woods to grandma's house we go.
Yeah, it's like not only, I felt like we were on an instant infomercial.
It was.
During the entire cruise, showing us this, that, and the other.
It was. It was like, we have this sale at this time, so you might want to come out. We have this thing going on at this time, you might want to come out. Well, you know, we want to teach you how to gamble. They even had classes teaching people how to gamble. And I was so excited. To the ship! Oh my, we're going to get on the ship, going through doors
and
doors of doors.
Already.
I don't know. I mean, it was like coming up.
My God.
I think we could finally see it through the windows there.
And there
And there it was. And we thought we, oh, look at that. I am just bright-eyed, bushy-tailed. The look of wonder. Little did I know, I didn't take any video coming off the ship, just to let you guys know, but I did take plenty of video coming on aboard, right? Come aboard? Come on board. And everybody else was excited. They're all, you know, some people traveled like hours and hours and hours to get there, and all we did was jump into an Uber. It was like a 10-minute ride. Oh, there's our Sea Pass card.
That will become your main source of gambling, drinking, getting in and off the ship. I mean, that's your lifeline. You use that in trouble.
Yeah, we were definitely, it's like that is everything that we could ever have. That little card. It has like our life savings on it, probably.
They're asking for this.
We were in because we had our card. I was so excited. And we were, I thought.
Have your cards out.
Oh, yeah.
You need those cards.
Another door. I think we went to door 20 there. Is it? Okay, now we're going, walking the gangplank. Oh yeah, I was
so cool.
Sniffing dog.
Oh, look at that.
Yep, way down there is a German Shepherd. Yeah, making sure that people didn't bring anything illegal. And our food was way back there, as we were to find out later how delicious everything was. It was delicious the first, you know, two or three days, and then it got to be a little repetitive towards the end, you know, a bit. But we had heard so much about this ship. We had investigated the ship. We knew this ship's dimensions. We knew how big the ship was, obviously. We knew every nook and cranny of the ship. So it's not like we discovered the ship. And I would definitely recommend that if you are going on a cruise, don't watch videos of it. You kind of kill the joy a little bit.
Why do people need that?
And here we are getting aboard. There's some Purell. We all needed to use Purell.
Oh, you get to.
And there I was on the ship. There we were. Finally.
We're on the ship.
Yes. We're on the ship.
And there's
said,
our
there's
food.
Our food over there. It's okay. Like, so what?
Oh, this is one of those.
And there's the lifeboat right? That we might need.
Right here, a lifeboat.
And
those things
helping
that one never has seen.
Sounds like a casino.
So surely, I'm thinking, definitely, we don't need to worry about videotaping any of this. We're just getting on the ship. That lady's nice enough. She's
pulls the card out of my hand.
Seems like she'd be.
Take my hat off.
Sorry.
She told me,
No,
you can't take video here.
I didn't think they were gonna let her in.
I'm gonna have to confiscate your camera. I was like, okay, gosh, I'm sorry, I didn't know. And there's the beautiful ship, the beautiful Independence of the Seas, Royal Caribbean's. Oasis line, or whatever they call it, Oasis class ship, massive thing.
With a bunch of shopping.
Lots of shopping. Hey. If you go to any mall, you might see this same view, except this is on a boat. But we had seen so many videos of this, we had no idea what it was before, but then later, as we got on the ship, everything came back to us. It was like, we had been here before.
But since I'm not a shopper, I mean, to me it's like, okay, why put a mall on the ship?
Yeah.
You know?
Well, I'm not a shopper either anymore. I used to be. But
everything from jewelry to watches.
We didn't even walk into one of the stores.
No. It's like,
I mean, it was like, we just wanted to do stuff that wasn't gonna like costs money. We already spent money to get on the cruise.
Plus, we're getting ready to go on a journey, and we have to downsize everything. So.
We're trying to get rid of stuff. We even like cut up our CPAS cards because we didn't want to carry that with us on the journey. I was like, can we just keep them as a memento? You're like, no, we're going on a journey. We can't keep a card.
You're hoarding stuff, and it's like...
It's a card, a little card. But you're right. We have the video. We have the memory in our head.
And the card is going to sit gathering dust, taking space, and, you know.
Oh, this pub, one of the days we're walking by, and there was this guy singing in it, and it was like, oh. That was not a talent that I would want to sit down and listen to. And there we are. I know you wanted pizza.
Yeah,
I know. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. But we did have two slices.
And that was all I got.
Two slices of pizza.
Because this one wanted to go to the buffet every time, three times a day. She could spare one day for me and a pizza. No,
I'm sorry. Hopefully, we'll be able to have pizza wherever on the road. Yeah, it is.
I'm wanting my pizza. I want a whole
pie. I didn't know you liked pizza that much.
I like vegetable pizza without cheese. You know, gluten-free.
We could have taken the toppings off of the other pizza and put other vegetables on it. I know, we could have lifted
the oils. Lifted.
Oh, I found out how the oils work. I don't want to know how the oils work. The oils work too well.
Yeah.
Too well.
Yeah. They put on the weight.
So, yeah, we're waiting for our room at this point. We're sitting, it's probably around 12:15 or so, and we had been told that our rooms would be ready by 1 o'clock. So we got on the ship early. Didn't have to deal with too much of that custom stuff, and you know, what you saw is what you saw. It does get worse, right? Sometimes for people getting on board.
Yeah, it can. I mean, it's pretty bad coming off.
Oh, that wasn't really sugar-free.
No, it was, but it's got aspartame in it.
The sugar-free isn't really sugar-free.
No, they just
isn't pounds free. Because even if you drink aspartamine or whatever,
it's like a Diet Coke, same concept.
Yeah. But you insisted on drinking it.
Oh no, I wanted the water thing, but
no, you didn't.
Water.
You didn't want water. You could have gotten water. You were like, I don't know, this is really good. It's tasty. I'm glad they have it.
They put stuff in there.
I'm glad they put it on the ship. So that's your bag, and those are my bags right there. We are minimalists now. Officially minimalists, and we sold another thing today, so yep, so it was 12:20 at that time.
And they're probably wondering why we are dubbing this, and they're probably going, why didn't they just leave the audio?
Well, you can hear some of it. Yeah, but the audio, I used a GoPro, and the GoPro housing, I guess, muffled the sound. I don't remember it doing that so much before, but this time
it did,
and it, you can hear some of it. It's not like so we're in waiting mode, just waiting.
It's pouring my shoulder out of there, so I can see my veins popping on my neck as that thing is pulling me.
We never used the elevator one time on this trip.
We used stairs all the time.
11 floors? No, more than that. Because it went from 1 to 12.
Yeah, back and forth. They did a lot of walking.
So there we were walking down our hallway.
Weight gain, though?
No, we'll talk about that later.
No, I know, but I'm just saying, all the walking we did.
No,
really
no, it doesn't.
So that throws
the fat and oils don't matter.
That throws the concept of, oh, just work out.
No. We worked out every day.
Every day in the gym.
And we still gain weight. And I still gained 10 pounds.
Imagine if we hadn't walked and worked out.
No, I can't imagine how many people have gained like 30 pounds on this trip.
1 year,
in 5 days. In 5 days. But these people, they took it to another level, a lot of them.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. But before I was, you know, really into eating healthy and the first couple of cruises that I did, I just pigged out.
Some of them couldn't even make it back inside their door.
I don't even think they fit in there. Look, yeah. If you think about it, look at the size of that.
Yeah.
And some of the people we saw there,
they were enormous.
Enormous.
And they got bigger.
It's one of the biggest wake-up calls after going on this cruise, seeing what Americana stands for. Overindulgence.
Overeating.
Overdrinking.
Bigger than the Prius.
And they look it.
Yeah.
They totally look it.
Wow, that's a nice bathroom.
There's a bathroom.
Oh, look at
that. That is nice. Yeah, and they have this round thing going on with the shower.
Yeah.
And
a nice shower head. And yeah. And like pulsating. Oh. And a famous
sucking toilet. Sucking. You know, I pushed the toilet thing with the lid open. Uh-huh. It wasn't that big of a deal.
But they always
single mattress. Just
in case.
Yeah.
Bed was very comfortable.
And we get to
it was. It's like a double, and then they have like another thing up top where you see the these the cutouts and stuff for bunk beds, but we didn't need that. I can't imagine four people in there.
Oh, I can't either.
It'd be like, excuse me, pardon me, pardon me, gotta breathe. So we had just gotten out of having some lunch there at the Windjammer and taking fruit, which was something that we had to leave, like six bananas behind, because you can't take any food off the ship.
No.
Apparently, everything has to stay on board. And the weather wasn't so hot.
That first day.
Yeah, it started to rain. That's why we're kind of walking under, you know, on the 11th level. Where the pools are.
And they had ice cream, which of course the line was always...
Look at that line, ice cream.
We didn't have any.
No. Well, it had dairy, but it didn't have dairy because it was some product.
But it still has dairy in it, even though it's...
But it was very, very, like, artificial.
Yeah, but...
You saw so much of the cartons and stuff, and it said vanilla flavor, chocolate flavor. It was nothing...
Nothing I would have wanted.
Back in the day, they used to have a line where they would serve ice cream, you know, on a spot, you know, where they would have flavors and stuff like that. And they did that the last day.
Yeah, but still no sherbet. I was hoping they would.
Yeah, no sherbet.
Because I don't do dairy. They're vegans, but, you know, they don't cater to vegans very well. I mean, we managed to substitute things, and you know, a couple of the meals that had vegan mock meat, but it was mostly beans, rice, potatoes.
That was our favorite little rocking chair thingamajig. One of the days we were rocking, and this man in a like one of those disabled scooters, he's like, it's a little loud because it creaks, you know, you can hear it in the video too, but. It's like, it's loud on the ship. You know, the wind is blowing, air is moving, people are talking, and they're complaining about...
I don't think he said it to complain. I think he's because he's probably heard it so many times as he goes by. So he says, that's a little loud.
And he was making rounds.
Yeah.
And this was very beautiful. I was very impressed. I mean, we didn't even have to leave port to go to the port that was the prettiest port of the whole journey. You know, this is Port Everglades, and they have like this beautiful state park. All this artwork that they had there, it's just kind of peculiar. I don't know if it had any rhyme or reason for being. They had these cool little computer things that you could find your way. And that was a really weird painting.
Yeah, they had a lot of strange paintings.
Like, it's an alien invasion. Of a ship getting sunk. I don't know why they would have a capsized ship on a cruise ship.
Because maybe that actually happened.
I don't think it did, but, you know.
I mean, there's even pictures of Jesus and UFOs behind him.
So we got, like, there we are at the, what is it, the drill.
Oh, yeah.
I thought we were going to have to put on the whole outfit thing and walk down like bumper cars with everybody else, you know.
No, they stopped that, thank God.
Yeah, I was grateful for that. But you have to meet, and instead of just doing a video or something, making people watch, everybody still has to gather and sit there and listen to people basically say, put on your life jacket.
It's like what they do in the airplanes, and they put their little thing on and show you how to do it.
Mm-hmm. But this is a lot more invasive, because everybody has to stop what they're doing, go to that drill area, that meeting area, and to wait there. But it was over as soon as it started. And all these people, so excited. Everybody's so excited.
4,000 plus people.
Yeah, it was crowded.
To me, it was too crowded. Hard to find seats for the buffets or New Year's. You always had to like struggle to find. And God forbid you would get up.
Oh my gosh, if you get up.
And your whole thing was gone. You're, you know.
I'm not going to say Royal Caribbean is the best cruise line,
no,
because we did not experience that at all. The shows were awesome. You know, the shows were amazing. But, you know, oh, I'm so excited. And there's the other side of the port, the pretty side. That cruise ship was huge. And it was, I guess it hadn't started raining yet because we were outside.
Oh, there's that big screen.
But it was windy up there. Most of the time it was windy up there, and you could literally lose your hat quite easily. We never did run on that track. It didn't look very inviting.
No.
We never did climb up that wall either, although that looked inviting. We just, I don't know, we never did.
Into the food coma.
No, we weren't into the food coma. We never really went back there after going there one time. I don't remember going back to that court.
We did.
We saw the water, but and we never saw that again after. I mentioned it, but didn't seem like you're the golfing type of person. But people were playing basketball and hanging out, and they have this really cool little, what they call a flow rider thing. And we never did that either, but we weren't planning on it. Yeah, it's still cool for people that want to take that chance, I guess. This is the back of the ship. And, yeah, people just enjoying what amenities the ship provides, and that's the rear of the ship right there. And again, such a beautiful location, and we would cruise away from here? It's such a pretty place, and the water was gorgeous.
What happened?
Well, for a beach, Fort Lauderdale.
You had hurt your leg or something, you said, in this part of the video. You were talking about how your ankle was hurting.
Yeah.
What happened?
I think it's from food. As soon as I ate it, inflammatory. Also, yeah, I don't react right.
Because at first you said it was your sandals or something. You were wearing sandals the other day, a few days before walking around. But yeah, you probably, my legs got, I know,
very
mine got swollen. And a distended gut too from, you know, you try to eat good, you try to eat healthy, but I mean, it's like we didn't even eat bad food, but everything on the ship is bad food. And it's like there's, unless you're just going to have fruit, which if it's good, you know.
And then the fruit, they had some fruit that was canned fruit that had high
concentration. Yeah, they had canned fruit on a cruise line.
I know.
When was that ever allowed to have canned fruit on a cruise line? And then towards the end, they had a orange juice cocktail.
Yeah, instead of, like, at first they were doing freshly squeezed, which I was loving. Very high in sugar either way, those juices or whatever, but it was good, you know, and then all of a sudden I replaced it with some concoction.
That's downtown Fort Lauderdale, way off in the distance. And I was just amazed at how pretty that is out there. Mm-hmm. Just
it's a lot more pretty than Cozumel's before.
Costa Maya. Well, those places have beautiful water, you know, but as far as, like, scenic, you know, this was really the prettiest port. Our own home port. Who even knew? We walk by here all the time. Well, not right here, but... And I was all anxious about getting on with the cruise. I saw the other ship leaving, and we ended up leaving early. I think we were heading out towards the gym.
I got the cootie, you know, I have this thing that all these people with germs touch everything. So really...
Everybody's looking so trim.
Yeah. And that's in the beginning of the cruise.
Oh, this is when it started to pour down rain. Yeah, it was...
There's the gym. The cruise is the workout time and the show. Tremendous shows.
The gym was really nice. It had really, really nice equipment. And my camera is out of focus. I'll blame the camera for that. I was using that little hand thing and I wasn't looking at my viewfinder. So. But yeah, I had towels provided, and they had all these machines. We never used the elliptical or the other thing. But isn't that awesome to be running with that as your backdrop? That's just very inspiring. There's the rowing machines. Just a lot of beautiful equipment. Beautiful people. It was nice. This is all the first day. We've taken lots of video of the first day because the first day was like, everything was so new. Independence of the Seas is like, we're so excited. Ship Shape Fitness Center, visited by maybe 5% of the people on the ship, including crew. We went every morning
before we ate
breakfast.
I always say earn your breakfast.
We never got in the pool though, or the spa, or whatever jacuzzi. And just look at all those people.
I mean, it
grossed us out even seeing that. Yeah. It's like germaphobes maybe, but you know, still.
I don't trust. I mean, you could get very sick on a cruise. And you got people from all over the world, and the germs, you know, are pretty potent. And just sitting around.
Oh, you had to check out towels.
Oh, yeah, and pay $25 if you didn't return them.
Yeah. So there we are on the top of the ship after it had rained a little bit. Nothing like a little rain. People still went out. We're in the pool and stuff afterwards. But it's so beautiful. That water, look it out behind that island. It's just gorgeous. That you still get that really nice blue out there. This video is almost winding down. People, those of you that have stuck it out with us here. But it's been... The first day was very nice. Very nice. It was cool watching the ship leave. I thought they were going to say, you know, like they did on the thing, you know, on the Love Boat where they go...
I thought they really cut a lot of corners. The service that is now being provided on cruise ships, it's not the same anymore.
It's not.
You know, it's like...
It's really not. It's nothing like it used to be at all. I cruised in 97 on Carnival, and it was more luxurious than this one, actually.
I cruised in 98 on Holland America, and I've gone on Princes. I've gone on Norwegian, I think I went, if I'm not mistaken, and mostly Holland America.
Now this was freaky. If you look closely, people, you'll notice that there's a soldier with a machine gun on a U.S. Coast Guard vessel, and that was escorting us out of port. Why? I do not know. I do not know why that was happening, but that was really bizarre.
It's 9/11. We live in a very strange world, and it's only getting stranger.
And they're like waving at the other boat as if it's like, oh, wonderful day. It's like,
just don't cross my path or I'll shoot you.
See you guys next video.